thank you very kindly. Have a really good day. Bye-bye. Hi, morning, Pally.
Morning, Peggy. How you doing?
Pretty good. Oh, I got a raisin up Danish for you.
Oh, thanks. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, Phoebe Jenkins was in this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's talking about buying a new car.
Yeah.
Well, that's the way she is. There you are.
Thanks.
So, how's everything going?
Okay.
Anything new or exciting?
Oh, my class has been invited to visit the governor.
Oh. Well, that's nice. Anything else?
Well, like what?
Well, like this new guy you've been dating, Carl? The one who moved here from Greensboro?
What about him?
Well, you all been out a lot together.
No, only about a half dozen times.
Like I said, a lot of times. So?
Yes.
Well, how's it going?
Fine.
Well, I mean, is it going to lead to anything?
Well, Peggy, I don't know, but if it does, I'm sure you'll know before I do.
And what is the capital of Delaware? Anybody?
I know, Miss Thompson, I know.
Yes, Deidre, I know you know. Does anybody else have a clue? Sandy.
Albuquerque?
Oh, Sandy, you just missed by just a couple of thousand miles, but thank you for trying. Now, y'all listen up. We are the only fourth grade class in the whole state to be invited to visit the governor. And we have to know our capital. We cannot go there ignorant of knowing which state has which city as its capital. Bye-bye.
Delaware.
Thank you, dear.
Well, afternoon, Miss Thompson.
Afternoon, Mr. Anderson. How are you?
Oh, I'm still kicking, but not high.
Cake. Are you having dinner here?
No, I'm going out with Carl.
Oh my gosh, how many times does this make it? He must be awfully interested in you.
Mama, there aren't a lot of single women in Orfax.
Well, there's Shilda and there's Phoebe Jenkins. And of course, you're the only one who's never been divorced, and that makes you more desirable. Do you like him, Pally?
He's nice, Mama. He's real nice. I just keep wondering if there shouldn't be more.
Don't say magic, Pally. Please do not say magic. Magic is for magicians, not husbands. You want a man you can trust, not one that pulls rabbits out of hats.
I know, Mama.
You have to stop being so picky, Pally. I mean, there's practically no candidates left. We're lucky this boy rolled in from Greensboro.
Where would it all go if we got married? We'd live in Orfax. I'd teach till I retired. Have two kids.
Oh, wouldn't that be wonderful? Here. Have some banana bread. You're too skinny, Pally. Men like when there's meat on the bones.
You don't like your ribs?
Mm, they're delicious.
You don't eat much, do you?
Don't tell me you think I'm too skinny, too.
Oh, no, no, I think you're just fine. Just the way you are. Now, when I moved to Orfax, I never thought I'd meet somebody like you.
Well, there must have been some nice women in Greensboro.
Oh, yeah, a last girlfriend I had, she liked me a whole lot. And she liked some dentist even better. They ran off together the night I bought tickets for Les Mis.
Well, maybe she just really didn't want to see that show.
Yeah, maybe that was it. You wanna take the ribs home? Do you have a dog there?
No, just a mother. Who would like you to come for dinner?
I accept. When?
Tomorrow night.
All right.
You know, I haven't been to that Bobby Rex Museum.
Oh, you're not missing anything.
Well, this town worships him.
Well, he's the only thing that ever came out of Orfax that anybody ever heard of.
I guess Bruce Springsteen did the same thing for Asbury Park.
Huh? I guess so.
Were you friends with Bobby Rex?
Oh, I wouldn't exactly call it friends. We were in the same class.
Garth Lamar.
Here.
Orse Lamar. Orse.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, are you here or not?
Here.
Hallie Thompson.
Here.
Bobby Rex.
Here.
I remember one time in English class, we were supposed to write out hopes for the future, what we wanted to be, and how it would affect the world around us.
I want to be a teacher like Mr. Witt.
Hallie, speak up a bit.
I like the idea of learning new things and passing that knowledge on to other people.
Shilda and Bobby Rex were the most gorgeous couple you ever did see. Shilda loved Bobby so much, it was almost unnatural.
I'd like to be an actress. Mostly in things written by Tennessee Williams like Cat on a Hot Tin Roof. Woo! So I can show the world the pain of the character and what a good actress I am.
Bobby Rex.
Bobby Rex was the most popular boy in school. Everybody knew he wanted to be a singer.
Love me tender.
No, not even a singer. A star.
All my
Shilda hardly ever took her eyes off him.
For my darling, I love you, and I always will.
And those are my plans for the future.
Oh, he sounds self-assured.
Oh, that he was.
Let's go in. Come on. Your friend Shilda works in there, don't you?
On Tuesdays and Thursdays.
It's Tuesday.
This must be Orfax.
Here's a picture of Bobby helping his mama take groceries into the house. And here on our next slide, we see the dentist office where Bobby had his braces taken off.
And our last slide is the Orfax Public Library, where Bobby allegedly received a card in 1966. Okay, are there any questions?
Where'd you and Bobby go for a day?
Well, in Orfax, there's really not a great deal to do. We would usually go to the movies, and then we'd get in his car and cruise around town, and of course, eventually park. You know the kind of things teenagers do. Any other questions?
Did Bobby take you to the prom?
No, he did not. He had already left Orfax by that time. But he did give me his class ring. Thank you all so much for coming.
Thank you. Oh, hi, sweetie.
Hi, Shilda. I'd like to meet somebody. This is Carl Chester.
Okay. Oh, so this is the guy, huh? Well, you lucky devil, you. So are you finally going to settle down, Pally Thompson?
Shilda, how's business?
Up and down. You know, it depends on Bobby's career. If he's number one in the charts, this place is jammed.
He's got a new single coming out any minute now, and we're just keeping our fingers crossed.
How you kid?
Monsters. You guys want them? You can have them.
No, no, thanks. But give them my love.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Nice to meet you.
Thanks. I had a real nice time.
So did I. It's a real nice kiss.
We'll see you tomorrow night.
I'm looking forward to it.
Through our good neighbor Tennessee and straight through Arkansas. You with me?
Yes, Miss Thompson.
Okay, now we're entering the great big state of Texas. We're going through Beaumont. We're passing through a huge cattle ranch. Watch out. Watch out, there's cattle crossing up ahead. Don't you step in anything. All right, we're in Houston now. Freeways everywhere. And now we are entering the capital of the state of Texas, which is...
Cheyenne.
Oh, Sandy, I think you took a wrong turn somewhere. I said west, not north. Come on back, Sandy, come on back. You're in Wyoming.
I know. The capital of Texas is Austin. A-U-S-T-I-N.
Hey, now, cut it out. If Deidre hadn't written an essay on how proud she is to be from North Carolina, none of us would have been invited to visit the governor.
All right, it's all for today. Work on it some more. We'll try again tomorrow. I tried. Do your homework, okay?
Any way we could expedite these children learning the capitals?
I'm working as fast as I can.
For the governor's office, each student will need a field trip pass, filled out and signed by the parent.
Yes, sir. Tomorrow.
Excuse me, Miss Thompson.
Hi, Mr. Anderson.
Rumor has it you need a light bulb.
Yes, indeed, I do. It's right up there.
Dolls, if you just sit tight, you're gonna hear the latest song by Mr. Bobby Rex. Right after this.
You were at Old Facts High the same time as Bobby Rex, weren't you, Miss Thompson?
Mm-hmm. If you are, I
once helped him fix his motorcycle.
Did you?
Were you good buddies with him?
No. No, we sat in the same part of class, because he was R for Rex, I was T for Thompson, but we're usually separated by a couple of S's.
Still, he must have talked with you quite often.
No, never. Matter of fact, he didn't notice me at all.
And I'll never forget. Oh, I'll never forget.
I think you noticed you, Miss Thompson.
today?
Mama, has Carl called?
No. He's still coming for dinner, isn't he? I made my very special beef tornadoes. Oh, I can hardly wait to meet that man. Pally, what's wrong with you? You're twitchy as a rabbit. Not again.
Here, Mama.
Hello? Hi, Courtney Jane.
Lamar twins, Mama. Well, tell them to come on in.
They can't. They gotta run.
It's all made up. You remember that?
If none of that ever happened, why did he write the song?
That is what I don't understand.
You haven't had some deep, dark, weird past that I don't know about.
No, Carl, not at all.
Oh, I mean, Pally, I wasn't born under a lucky star when it comes to women. And I've gotten fooled a couple of times.
I swear to you, ask anybody in town. I've always been Little Miss Goody Two-Shoes.
You hear stories all the time about how the one you thought was Miss Goody Two-Shoes turns out to be Miss Kinky Roundheels.
Not me.
Is it possible that Bobby Rex had a crush on you and you didn't even realize it?
Oh, absolutely impossible.
Well, maybe he was in love with you instead of Shilda, and it just took all these years for it to surface.
Sweet of you to suggest, but no, there's no way in hell Bobby Rex was ever interested in me.
Sometimes men keep a lot of their feelings hidden.
No, Bobby Rex didn't keep much of anything hidden. Oh, this is a small town. Don't tell him what's going to happen now.
Listen, Pally. Even though we haven't known each other for very long, I believe what you tell me. And I will stick by you, whatever happens.
Mama.
You dirty, rotten lion.
Scram! I'm a little trick.
Oh.
Who is it, Pally?
It's just Shilda, Mama. Shilda, it never happened. Shilda. My best friend. My very best friend in the whole wide world. I trusted you. I turned to you.
Shilda, I never had anything to do with Bobby Rex. The two of you were together all the time. He never even spoke to me. You know that?
That's what I saw, but obviously something else went on behind my back.
There wasn't.
That's why he left Orfax. That's why he didn't take me to the prom. It was because of you. It was all because of you.
Oh, it wasn't.
Then why didn't he write a song about me, huh? I was his damn girlfriend. I'm the one that's been lecturing about him for the past 10 years.
I know that, Shilda.
Why didn't he write a song called Pally Thompson, huh? Why didn't he write a song called Shilda Hawk? I mean, what's wrong with Shilda Hawk? Isn't Shilda Hawk a nice name?
It's real nice.
Then why didn't he use it for a song?
I don't know.
Oh, you better find out. Otherwise, you're going to be in deep trouble.
Hi.
It's my dad.
Morning, class.
Good morning, Miss Thompson.
No talking. Well, it's bright and early, and no doubt your minds are sparkling fresh. All right, let's try again. The state of Ohio. Anybody? Sandy!
Columbus?
Yes, Sandy, good. Good for you. Good. What else do you remember?
Whopping!
That you can memorize. How many of you have heard Bobby Rex's new song?
Oh, me!
I know the whole thing by heart.
I bet you do. The assignment for this evening is to listen to the song and be prepared to discuss it in class tomorrow. Yeah. Why don't we move on to math? Turn to page 32 in your book.
And that's our very own North Carolina's Bobby Rex whomping his heart out for Pally Thompson. That song has sizzle, and I'm going to play it for you all day long. Next up, Whitney Houston's gonna soothe your soul.
I tried to raise you the best I could. I thought you were a good girl, Pally.
Mama, you know I've always been a good girl. I mean, practically always. It's bogus, all of it. I don't even like jelly, Mama, you know that.
Yes?
Pally Thompson?
Speaking.
Hi there, my name is Brenda Sands. I'm calling from Fever Beat Magazine, and I'm wondering if you are the Pally Thompson in Bobby Brooks' new song.
Well, I might not be.
What are you talking about?
Well, he might know another Pally Thompson.
Well, you are the one who went to school with him.
My researchers found your name in the Orfax High School yearbook.
Well, we did go to high school together, but that doesn't mean that I'm...
Well, we would
love to do an interview with you for the magazine.
Oh, no. No, I couldn't do that.
No? Why not?
I just could.
Oh, come on, Pally, you owe it to your public.
My public?
All those people out there dying to know the intimate details of you
and Bobby. What do you say?
But none of it's true.
Yeah, well, that's what they all say when the song first comes out. Remember Christy Brinkley and Uptown Girl and Rosanna Arquette when Toto wrote Rosanna. And I don't know if you know this, but even Yoko
was into some denial.
But he made up the whole damn thing.
What if we pay you $1,000?
No, no, that's not the point.
Oh. Okay, let's make it $2,000.
No, it's not a matter of money.
I'd be happy to come down to Orville.
Orfax.
Wherever.
Look, Miss Sands, I thank you for your offer, but I have to sort things out here. Bye. Excuse me. Can I help you?
I'm Mrs. Sherwin.
Yes?
Well, I'm the substitute for today.
Well, I'm the teacher. I'm Miss Thompson, and I'm here.
All I know is I got the call at 6 o'clock this morning to take over this class for a week.
Who called you?
Jeremy Stitcher, the principal.
I tried to head you off at the pass. Tried to call you this morning, but your line was busy. I guess a lot of people were calling you.
Is
lost a stitcher. What exactly is going on?
Why don't we all meet in the teacher's lounge in a half an hour?
According to Geraldine LaRusso's mother, you asked the children to listen to the song and come in and discuss it as a class assignment.
Is that true, Miss Thompson?
Yes, it is.
Why on earth would you encourage them to listen to it?
Because I thought it was best to get it out in the open, to discuss it frankly. I mean, these kids listen to these songs all day long anyway. They're a lot more sophisticated than we give them credit for.
This is not just any song. It's about the teacher. It's about the teacher doing obscene things.
None of that ever happened.
Miss Thompson, Pally, under the circumstances, I'm afraid we're going to have to suspend you.
Why? Because somebody used my name in a song? I mean, what if my name was Lovely Rita Meter Maid?
Oh, come on now. Who has a name like that? And besides, Rita the Meter Maid didn't do any of the things you did.
The facts, Miss Thompson, are he used both your names. You lived in the same town, and you both went to the same school together. Ergo, the song is about you.
He used my name, but he invented the other things, ergo.
It's quite unfortunate this town revolves around the likes of Bobby Rex. He was a licentious little boy, and now he sings licentious little songs.
Oh, Brenda, somebody from Fever Beat magazine called here, looking for information about you, and Playboy magazine called. They're interested in doing a spread on unusual elementary school teachers. Well, we just can't have any of this.
And we certainly can't have the children taken to see the governor by a porno queen.
Marianne, for heaven's sake. Mr. Stitcher, we've been planning this trip. The children...
I'm sorry, Pally.
I'm really sorry about what happened in there.
Yeah, me too.
I mean, this is really some crazy thing that happened.
Your Stitcher didn't even want to hear my side of it. He hired that substitute before he even talked to me. I mean, was this a unilateral decision? You're the assistant vice principal. Did he check with you?
Well, he did call me last night, and he said a few parents had called to protest.
I can't believe this is happening.
I know how upset you must be, Pally. Pally, I was thinking maybe one afternoon we could have lunch together. A long lunch. My wife still thinks I'm teaching them afternoon classes.
There she is. Right there.
Thompson? Pally Thompson?
What?
My name is Donald Pierce. I'm with Dunmar, Dunmar, and Rogers over in Greensboro.
Yes?
I'm here to help you, Miss Thompson.
Help me what?
Bobby Rex used your name in a song without your consent. He exposed your private sex life to the entire country.
We didn't do any of it.
I tried to find you through the school. They told me you'd been suspended. Suspended from your job as a teacher, a servant of the community.
Can you believe that?
Now, Miss Thompson, we could not only sue Bobby Rex, but the record company as well. Now, I believe in these issues to such a degree that I would be willing to take this case on a contingency basis.
I want to find out why he wrote the damn song in the first place before I think about suing him.
This may be an opportunity you don't want to miss. Now, here's my card. You think about it. You have been libeled, Miss Thompson.
Yes, Olympus Records.
Ma'am.
I was wondering if you could help me. This is Pally Thompson speaking. Now, recently, you recorded a song. What's so funny?
You say your name is Pally Thompson.
Well, I am Pally Thompson.
That's what they all say.
Well, they're all imposters.
That's what they all say, too.
Bring him up a little higher, okay?
I'll work on it.
Brenda Sands. Well, hi, Pally. How are you doing?
I would like to do that interview with you.
Well, smart thinking, Pally.
There's one condition.
Well, there always is.
You got to get me a meeting with Bobby Rex. I want to find out why the hell he wrote that song.
I like it. I like it.
Beg pardon?
In fact, I love it. Megastar reunited with his high school sweetheart.
Great tabloid. Can we pull this off?
Okay. We will surprise him at his concert at the Wiltern. I'll get all the media there.
Sit tight, Pally. I'm going to get right on it,
and I'll touch base with you tomorrow. And hey, congratulations.
Congratulations?
Yeah, you just entered the world of celebrity.
Help yourself to the exhibit. The lecture starts in 15 minutes.
It's me.
Who do you want, Snake?
Shilda, I gotta talk to you.
About what? You know, they wanted to replace me here at the museum.
And guess with who?
You. Said I wasn't current enough.
Oh, Shilda, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, I bet you are. Who do you want to talk to me about?
Shilda, do you still think Bobby Rex is the way we remember him?
How am I supposed to know? I spend all my time trying to forget him. I don't know how I can with this job, though. All I ever do is just talk about him. It's easier forgetting my ex-husband.
Bobby Rex was your big love.
He hurt me that so gun.
I know he did. Do you want to meet later so we can talk?
All right. But you're not going to hang around here, are you? Because I'm just nothing with you here.
No, when you get off, I'll be out by the tracks. Still working full-time at the restaurant?
Yeah, 40 hours a week. My kids are money machines.
Well,
nothing much has changed around here, has it?
No. Every time I'd see a train pull out of here, I'd wish I was on it. Want to go someplace where people didn't know me. Have an image of me. And I could be more like I wanted to be. More confident. Savvy. Happier.
Yeah, well, I got on that train and look where it got me. Right back here at Orthax with two kids and no child support.
No, but at least you went to the edge.
The edge? Honey, I fell in.
Is this what you wanted to talk to me about, train
no.
ride?
I'm going out to L.A. to see Bobby Rex.
Home. For heaven's sake, Shilda, talk to Bobby all these years.
You have always been jealous of me, haven't you? I was better looking than you. I had a great body, and I had Bobby. I had everything you wanted. You were just as plain as an old paper bag, and the only thing exciting about your life was that I was your friend.
Well, that's probably true,
and
Shilda, but that still doesn't mean...
Well, okay, fine. You
just go to L.A., you little tramp. And another thing, you can tell Bobby that if he's interested, old Shilda is single again.
I can't talk you out of it.
I had no choice. This isn't going to blow over like some summer storm. I want my life back.
And how will going to Los Angeles bring it back?
I want to talk to Bobby. I want to find out why he wrote it. And I want him to sign this.
I, Bobby Rex, do hereby admit that all lyrics in the song Pally Thompson have been invented and never happened.
You really think a note from Bobby Rex will convince everybody?
I could have some kind of proof. I don't know what else to do. Between my job and Mama and Shilda and this town.
It got kind of chilly out. I want you to catch a cold. So you're not going to be in Los Angeles for too long, are you?
No, just as long as it takes to get this done.
I miss you. I wouldn't want anything to come between us. You know, I mean, things have been going pretty good so far. And I wouldn't...
I'll be back in the blink of an eye.
Mama, you sure you're going to be okay?
Oh, I'm sure.
I'm only going to be gone 2 days. I'll call as soon as I get there. Okay?
What?
And can you make it out to Amy? That's with an I-E at the end. Oh, would you give this to Bobby Rex? It's my phone number.
Oh, Mama, I gotta get out of here.
Here's our schedule. We'll drop you off at the hotel, we'll give you a couple of hours to rest and fix yourself up, and then we'll be back at 7 sharp. We've got to go over strategy, stake our territory. We need the moment you and Bobby see each other for the first time.
Pally, are you paying attention to me?
What are you looking at?
Everything. Never been outside North Carolina.
You gotta be kidding.
I wish I were. Where are we?
The Majestic Hotel.
It's beautiful.
It's yours for the night, dear. We'll be back in 2 hours. Maybe you want to go downstairs and buy yourself something to wear.
Welcome to the Majestic.
Now, girls, today's home economics lesson will concentrate on how to fix a flawed face. Our first volunteer, Pally. The shape of this face is too round. Correct with darker foundation at the cheekbone. Complexion, too pale. Makeup and blush on needed desperately. Dishwater blonde, limp. Lusterless. Recommend permanent and conditioner. Oh, disaster area. Hangnail problem. Looks like somebody used a pencil sharpener instead of a nail file. Now, remember, use darker foundation to contour so face doesn't appear too round, too round, too round, too round. Too round.
Pally.
Where are you going?
I have to go scout out our locations. Don't move.
Testing. Testing. 1, 2, 3.
Good evening. The Wiltern Theater is proud to present one of the great stars of our time, Mr. Bobby Rex.
Satisfy her, or she begs for more and more.
Oh, yeah. I want to nab Sting this way.
Hi, Brenda Sands from Free Movie Magazine. We got a surprise for you, Bobby. All the way from Wopat, your old girlfriend, Pally Thompson.
We got,
Say something, Pally.
Pally?
I want you to sign this.
I, Bobby Rex, do hereby admit that all lyrics in the song Pally Thompson have been invented and never occurred. How could you do this to me? All those things you wrote, all those lyrics, they never happened. Who do you think you are to write a song about me? I've been expelled from my job as a school teacher. You humiliated my mother. You ruined my life.
Who the hell are you?
It checks out. She was in high school with you.
The lawyers think you should contact her. You can't afford any trouble. What could she possibly do? She's got grounds for a case. It'll be hard to prove you don't remember who she is. What do you want me to do?
What you do best.
Charm her out of it.
I can do that.
What did you do?
Oh, Brenda, I'm so sorry. I really am. I ruined it.
11 years and never have I been thrown out of anyone's dressing room.
Well, it wasn't my fault.
That man doesn't even know who you are. What are you, some kind of phony?
No!
Do you have any idea how much money we laid out to get you to come here? Do you know how much it cost to get you to fly from Tooleyville? You have made a fool out of me.
Made a fool out of myself.
Oh, who cares? I have a magazine to answer to. You tricked me. No. And Brenda Sands does not like to be tricked.
The bellhop.
How you doing, Pally?
How am I doing?
Listen, about last night, I'd like to apologize.
Apologize?
I just wasn't prepared for you, that's all. My bouncer was having a bad day, and... Well, look, anyway, I'd like to make it up to you. How about going out to dinner with me tonight?
Dinner tonight?
Yeah, we could talk. Sort things out. Talk about the old days.
I guess so. Yes.
Great. I'll pick you up at 8. Bye, ma'am.
I just love this smoked eel salad. They make it especially for me. It's got those red beans in it I like. What do you call them?
Kidney beans.
Yeah, kidney beans. You know, I like lima beans, too. What kind of beans do you like? String beans, garbanzo beans, pork and beans?
You have no idea who I am, do you?
Not exactly.
You know, I wasn't real memorable. I'm still not, but I was Shilda's best friend.
Shilda.
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 The Lamar twins, C.B. Jenkins, Orville Zinbar, our fourth grade teacher, Mr. Fitzpatrick.
Who used to put shoe polish on his bald
spot?
Yes,
right. Yes. Yeah. So you do remember me?
Not at all.
So, Bobby Rapp. If you don't remember me, why on earth did you write a song about me?
That's a good question.
Well, it's not about you, per se. Your name just came to me from the recesses of my mind. I guess probably because I heard it every day and when they called roll call in school.
Well, because my name got stuck in the recesses of your mind like a poor fly in a spider's web. My life has been a wreck.
Well, I really apologize for that. If this has caused you any grief, I'm really sorry. You can see it was inadvertent, and if there's anything I can do to make it up to you, to Pally Thompson.
Me or the song?
Oh. What do you think?
It's gorgeous.
You never got out of Orfax.
No, still doing time.
How come?
I don't know. I always wanted to go someplace else. I just never knew where that someplace else might be.
Haven't you ever had a name just pop into your head? Or dreamt about someone you barely knew?
Oh, yes. I once had a dream about Spiro Agnew. I never understood why.
Spiro Agnew.
You know, Shilda was real ticked off you didn't write a song about her.
How is Shilda?
Oh, she's great.
Whatever happened to her?
Well, she got married. She got two boys. They're cute, but bratty. She's single again.
Shilda was a real fun girl.
It took her a long time to get over you, Bobby.
What'd I do?
You don't remember that either?
Well, yeah, some of it I do.
You were both saving up all your money to buy her a diamond ring. Then you took all that money and you went to Nashville to enter a song contest.
I won first place.
You broke Shilda's heart. She never heard from you again.
I feel bad about that. I'll send her a check.
Oh, I almost forgot. Here.
What's this?
Well, a teenager in Orfax wanted me to give you her phone number. There now, I've delivered all the messages I was supposed to.
When are you heading back?
In the morning.
You think you could put it off another day? You think you could go back the day after? I've been enjoying myself with you. And you're beginning to look real familiar to me now. What do you say?
No, I don't think I should.
Oh, come on. Just one more night. For old time's sake.
Okay.
Great.
You can't believe it. The guy wants to know what restaurant.
He's thinking maybe she liked the Hard Rock.
Dude, why another dinner?
I don't know. I haven't seen her in a long time. You know how it is when you run into an old buddy.
2 days ago, you didn't even know who she was.
Look, you seem to have calmed her down, and she's not going to start any lawsuits. Why don't you leave well enough alone?
I'm only talking about one more dinner. I don't see what the big deal is.
You're playing with fire, boy.
Forecast tomorrow, low clouds tomorrow. High around 75.
Hello? Hi, Mama. Pally, honey, how are you? I'm going to pick you up at the airport at 3 o'clock.
I'm not coming home today, Mama.
Why not?
I'm going to stay one more night.
Well, why is that?
I'm having another dinner with Bobby Rex.
Mama? Well, why are you going to do that?
Well, we just still have stuff to talk about.
Pally Marie, you're going to get yourself in a heap of trouble.
Mama, we have to resolve this problem.
You're playing with fire, girl.
Then you got up and you sang Love Me Tender.
Remember that.
And I talked about my desire to become a teacher.
Well, I guess we both got what we wished for.
Mm-hmm. Where are we headed?
To a party. Is that all right with you?
Bobby, I need you here for a second. Can you come with me?
I'll be right back.
Hi there.
Hi.
You, work for Bobby?
No, I'm just a friend. I'm Pally Thompson.
Right. And I'm Peggy Sue.
Pally! Here,
I want to tell you something. I'm telling you, she's beautiful. I'd like to propose a toast. Pally Thompson. This little lady's song as of tonight is number one on the charts.
All right!
You're giving me a hit, you mystery woman of my memory.
Bobby, do you remember in the 12th grade? You bumped into me and my books fell all over the place. Do you remember that?
All I can think of right now is that you smell real good. Want to see my house?
Is it far from here?
We're in the driveway.
No.
Yes?
No.
Yes.
Long way from your house on Mosley Road.
That it is.
Well, the screens were always falling off. Why was that?
They didn't fit. We were too poor to buy new ones.
And that's the Bobby Rex Museum, main attraction of Orfax.
Orfax. A million years ago. Sometimes I miss those days. The quiet of it, the simplicity. You remind me of that.
Sometimes I feel like I got stuck in time. Like I'm gonna grow old and change on the outside without ever changing on the inside.
You remember my mama and daddy?
Sure I do.
I bought them an estate in the Bahamas.
How nice. How are they?
Yeah, they're fine. I don't get to see them much.
They were sweet people.
Just like you. I like your face.
You don't think it's too round?
I don't think it's too anything. What's the matter?
I don't think we should do that.
Why not?
Sure.
I like you. You are so sweet and so real, so pure. Sometimes I think I was destined to write that song.
It's the biggest line I've ever heard.
little.
Pally.
What?
You want to see the upstairs?
No.
It's real pretty.
I'm sure it is.
Oh, come on, just for a second.
Maybe one little itty bitty second.
What do you want to do today, anyway?
Well, I'm going back to North Carolina.
Oh, don't be silly. We are going to have a grand old time.
Bobby Rex, what do you want to hang around with me for?
Oh, because you feel like home. Because you're good and kind. And because you liked me before I got famous.
Well, I didn't really.
What do you want for breakfast?
Well, you got any raisin nut Danish?
How's the Danish?
It's delicious. I feel terrible.
About what?
About Shilda.
Shilda?
Well, you were her boyfriend.
Pally, that was 17 years ago.
Doesn't matter.
Well, anyway, we were never lovers.
Don't be ridiculous. Of course you were.
No, we weren't.
Well, you're wrong.
I'm not wrong. I was there. I know.
Wait a minute. Are you telling me that you never...
Never.
Well, no, Shilda told me. I mean, she gave me long... detailed reports about you. Oh, no.
That's funny.
Oh, places you can go in your imagination.
Did you ever imagine this, young lady?
What? Oh,
this is David Haskell from Daily Entertainment. Super rock star Bobby Rex was reunited with the real Pally Thompson, girlfriend from hometown Morfax, North Carolina.
I'd like to propose a toast to Pally Thompson. This little lady's song as of tonight is number one on the chart.
All right!
At Olympus Records party to celebrate Wopat Pally Thompson becoming number one in the country, they were the shining couple, never leaving each other's side. The party lasted until the wee hours of the morning.
I'm glad. Hello. Hi, Mama. You're not going to be on flight 566, are you? How'd you know? Just a mother's instinct. What are you doing there, Pally?
Oh, I'm just kind of getting reacquainted with Bobby Rex.
You don't know him well enough yet?
Just a little bit more, Mama.
Pally, you better give Carl a call.
I will. I love you. Bye.
Buenos dias. Fruta.
Thank you.
That's lovely. Bobby?
Yeah?
Brenda Sands wants to come to the house and interview me for Fever Beat magazine. She says I owe it to her.
Go ahead and do it.
Well, what do you want me to say?
Anything you want. As long as you tell people to keep buying your record. Oh, look at this. It's the itinerary for next week's tour.
Oh, Lost Cities.
You want to come?
Toddy City?
Sure, we'd have fun.
What would I do?
Keep me company, make me happy.
After you were happy, I mean.
I don't know. You can do whatever you want. Shop. Oh, this is a kick.
What is it?
They want to put my picture on the front of this cereal box. That is fantastic.
You know, I wonder if they did that with the presidents. It would help the kids learn who they were.
Which presidents?
Of the United States.
Just think, every kid out there munching Odies and buying my records. Yes, sir.
Oh, would you please pass the crate?
Bless you.
Excuse me.
I hope you're not catching cold.
Must have been that beach party we went to the other night.
Listen, I want you to be careful.
No, I will.
You can't get too close to me. I can't afford to catch cold.
That you really love me. Baby, you've been lying again. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Dear Miss Thompson, hope you are fine. Hope Bobby Rex is fine. Next week we are going to visit the governor. It's weird that you're not going with us. I know I talk all the time, and I don't know the answers. But I like you, Miss Thompson. Do you think you could ever come back and be our teacher?
Cut the tape. Hold on.
All right, let's back it up. You know, we're just never going to get out of here.
Yeah,
right.
I know.
Just settle down, okay. Let's
what do
let's
I
have,
need?
Let's have a little more reverb.
Make it brighter this time.
A substitute is nice, but not as special as you. Yours truly, Sandy. P.S. The capital of California is Sacramento.
I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Pally? Pally, come here a minute.
Yes? What is it?
Does it look like I'm getting a little flabby back here?
No. No, Bobby. No.
Must be the angle. Hey, listen. You gonna go on tour with me?
I don't know.
Why the hell not? You got something better to do?
Well, I got a letter from one of my students. It sort of choked me up. They're going to visit the governor next week. It's something that we've been planning together for a year.
I swore I saw some flap. Must be that mirror.
Bobby?
Hmm.
I'm going back to Orfax.
Oh, yeah? What's up?
I want to.
Who would want to go back to Orfax?
It's where I belong.
got its flaws, but it's my home.
Pally, you could do so much better.
What's better? I don't know. I used to think in Orfax everyone was obsessed with everyone else's business, but it's the same everywhere. Plus, there are people here that are completely obsessed with themselves. Now, which is worse?
Are you saying that I'm self-centered? Is that what all this means?
Hey, look, I gotta protect myself. Everybody wants a chunk of me. They always have, ever since I was a little kid. Even you want some, you know it.
Well, you may be right about your chunk.
Hey, I am the way I am.
Yes, and it's worked for you. It always will.
Well, why don't you stay?
Because it's not me. It's not remotely me. I'm a teacher in a small town. It's not glitzy, but it's me. It's my life.
You don't like me much, do you?
Yes, I do. You've been sweet to me.
Why do you have to leave?
Because we have the past in common, Bobby Rex. But not the present.
It's been a great 2 weeks.
Well, goodbye, Bobby Rex.
Bye, Pally. He had a
good run. Did you, sign this, please?
We thought we could work it out.
You realize that now, of course, the lyrics to the song are true. There. We had some good times, didn't we?
Thank you for everything, Bobby. Truly.
Remember this way.
Take care of yourself.
You keep me out of your songs now.
Okay.
No matter how far, my love goes with you.
Am I still the talk of the town?
You most certainly are. Except for 2 days when Courtney Jane's chickens got some weird disease.
Oh, look at this.
Ah. Oh, no. Oh, I gotta do something about this hair. What do you think, Pally?
Oh, I think it looks just fine, Mama.
What is it about hair that makes you feel that if you arrange it in a new style, that you're in a new style, too?
Am I gonna be able to pick up the pieces, Mama?
Well, you're gonna need an awful lot of glue.
Pick up number 7.
What are you doing here, slumming?
I'm back. Good.
Did Bobby dump you?
Doesn't matter what happened.
By the way, did you get a check?
What?
Miss, are you sure this is decaf?
You said decaf, didn't you?
Hello there.
So, did he ask about me? Constantly. Constantly. He wanted to know every little detail of your life. Well, so what happened with you all?
Oh, nothing much.
Well, you probably weren't his type, you know.
Probably.
Well, you had your adventure, didn't you? You had your train ride. He's a great lover, isn't he? Oh, he was so passionate back then. He was the greatest lover I've ever had.
Miss Thompson has called this meeting to ask us to reinstate her as a teacher of the fourth grade.
My civil liberties have been violated, and if you continue to keep me out, I'll be forced to press charges against you and the school.
Are you threatening us, Miss Thompson?
I'm saying that I'm willing to resort to legal means if that is necessary.
We won't be intimidated by Miss Thompson. The question is, will she be setting a poor example for the children?
I understand the children have been asking for Miss Thompson to return.
Is that true?
Not all the children. We have the interests of the children at heart.
And so do I. I spend every day with those children. I care about what they put into their minds. They know me. They know who I am and what I represent. Believe me, they put this in a much better perspective than all of you. Here we are. Okay. Come on. All right, troops, we have arrived. Now remember, no talking and no touching anything. And observe it all. This is a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Congratulations. Come on.
Thank you. Good morning, and welcome, boys and girls of the fourth grade class of Orfax Elementary School. You know something? You are our future leaders in this fine state, and I know that one day you're going to make each and every one of us very, very proud of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Enjoy yourself.
How do you do, Governor? Pally Thompson.
Oh, yes. Yes, Miss Thompson. I've heard about you. I know what you've been going through. People oftentimes during my career have written things about me that I wish they hadn't. But I think we can prevail, don't you, Miss Thompson?
Yes. Yes, we can, Governor. Fine, thanks. How are you?
Pretty good. I haven't seen your name in the magazines for a while.
Oh, I'm yesterday's news.
Oh, I got some freshly baked raisin nut Danish for you.
Great. No, wait. On second thought, let me try the blueberry muffins. Two of them. Blueberry muffins?
Mm-hmm.
Two of them? And two cups of coffee.
For you and someone else?
No, I'm just hungry, Peg.
All right, these headers, I want to raise them up 6 inches.
Hi.
Got it.
Hello, Pally.
Brought you some coffee and muffins.
Oh, thank you. I already had some breakfast.
Oh. Do you have a minute?
Yeah.
I know you're disappointed in me. I know you've been hurt before.
Don't you worry about me, Pally. I'll be fine.
I did something impulsive. Something I felt I had to do.
You know, things seem to be going well between us. I thought we were building something here.
We were. I'd like it to continue.
What do you need me for? You're famous now.
Famous for 15 minutes.
I can't compete with a Bobby Rex. I'm not a rich rock star.
I'm not asking you to be.
How do I know you won't go running off again?
The next time somebody writes a song about me, it's not likely to happen in this century.
Or the next time something more exciting comes your way?
No, I've gotten that notion out of my head.
Pally, I've been made a fool of in this town.
You be here with his head to ring?
You could never be that. Anyway, who cares what anyone in this town thinks? It only matters what you think. And what I think. And feel. You matter to me, Carl. You matter to me a lot. Can I see you later? Can we have dinner later?
Pally, I don't know. I don't know.
Okay. Please give me another chance.
Pick you up about 7 o'clock.
I'll see you then.
All right. Bye-bye.
Caller number 5. And now I have a treat for all you faithful FJIV listeners. Guess who just came out with a new song? You got it. Here's the latest by Mr. Bobby Rex.
I feel good, so very good. The sun is shining in my life. I feel strong like I belong, 'cause I got you, Doreen,
Doreen, my